for Mr. Dubuis since the beginning. It was very important to highlight the tourbillon. And that it's really a tribute to him.
Hi, Gregory.
Hi.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you
Could
for
you
coming.
Could you please give us an insight to your role a bit?
Okay. My name is Gregory. I am in charge of the project in Roger Dubuis, and it's a very the organization in Roger Dubuis is a bit particular because I am in charge of product marketing, design, and R&D. The reason of this organization is because the product is very important in the company. It's the reason why we put all these departments together. I joined the company in 2002, a long time ago, and in the past I was very close to Mr. Dubuis in terms of development and watchmaking.
That's so interesting. Let's start with the releases. Exciting new things, everything a bit around the tourbillon.
Yes.
And we have one of the highlight pieces here.
Yeah. The tourbillon is really the main topic today for Roger Dubuis. It was very important to share with everyone why we developed tourbillon in Roger Dubuis and what is important and specific in the Roger Dubuis tourbillon. And to illustrate that, this piece is really very interesting because we come back to the beginning of the brand when Mr. Dubuis developed launched his own company. His vision was really to create very modern watches, but with real watchmaking content. And that is the beauty of this product, because front you have a very modern and original design, but when you turn the watch, you can see the finishing and the quality, the high quality of the movement, and particularly highlighted by the Geneva seal.
So exciting. Can you talk a little bit more about the inspiration behind and the heritage of the brand?
The inspiration for Mr. Dubuis, when we start with the tourbillon, his idea was really to come with something different. It's the reason why we positioned the cage at between 7 and 8 o'clock, and we developed a very big cage, tourbillon cage. That was very the starting point of the evolution of the tourbillon in Roger Dubuis, because with this not symmetrical position for the cage, that influenced also the design of the skeleton in the future. It was very important to play with this symmetry. It's the reason why the skeleton of Roger Dubuis is very different than the other brand, because we all the time try to find a balance between all the elements to have a beautiful watch.
And iteration, yes.
For this one, for Mr. Dubuis since the beginning, it was very important to highlight the tourbillon. That it's really a tribute to him, to put the cage in the center of the movement and to play with the 3D. And I think it's the reason why our central tourbillon is very original and different than the other one. It's really because we highlight the tourbillon is really on the top of the movement, and we play with 3D with the trajectory of the hour. It's very deep in the movement.
Would you say it sets a new standard for the brand?
It's a new area for the brand, particularly to highlight the watchmaking. We really want to come back to that, to come back to traditional complication, but reinterpret with a modern twist. And that is really the starting point of a new area.
What would you say is the most exciting aspect of like developing a new complication or like bringing it further?
I think for Roger Dubuis is different than the other brand. For Roger Dubuis, we are a very young brand and we like to take risks. We don't have dogma. And I think sometimes the watchmaking industry is a bit close on the very we capitalize to the past and not we project ourselves in the future. And for the brand, for GDB, it's really, we are more to take a risk and to imagine something not possible to do today. And that it's really the beauty when you start a new project is, it's impossible to do that. It's good, we will do that because nobody wants to do that. And it's really our duty to test and to challenge ourselves.
It's like blending heritage and innovation. So would you say it's a direction that you want to develop further for the next years?
Yes, also because it was the beginning of the brand. It was really the vision of Mr. Duby. Mm-hmm. And some client asked me, how do you manage that? How do you manage to be very avant-garde, very expressive, very innovative, but with a traditional content? In fact, Mr. Duby gave us the solution of that. It's really to play with the two face of the watch, and I think this one is the perfect example for that.
You already said that you worked with Mr. Roger Duby. Is there like something you learned from him, or how was it working with him?
I learned everything with him. No, for the main learning I received from him, favorite sentence was all the time, be innovative but respect the watchmaking tradition. And for that, don't hesitate to take inspiration to the past and project the watch in the future. That I think is the best learning I received. In this watch we did that. We study a lot the old project and we find a solution in a very old anonymous pocket watch. To find a solution to set the time and to have a very original mechanism of setting time. And that it's a good learning I received from him. It's really to don't hesitate to study the past and to adapt that in the future.
What were challenges? I mean, it's a complicated product. And also for the other novelties, you played with Titanium. What were challenges in terms of product and maybe for the brand in the last year or the last month?
I think the most challenging thing when you are in a brand like Roger Duby, it's to stick around. Mm-hmm. Because we don't have a long history and we can go in plenty of different directions. And it's very important to be sure when we develop a new product that supports the vision of the founder and the vision of the brand. And the full titanium, for me, it's a very good example because for Jeu Duby, for Mr. Duby, it was all the time very important to have something coherent. Mm-hmm. And we make the decision to develop a very modern tourbillon. Mm-hmm. And for that, we change the performance of the movement, we increase the power reserve, we increase the magnetic resistance, we increase the design to have a very modern design. And at the end, to have the perfect watch, we didn't take steel, because steel is not modern material. And we move to titanium because it's more comfortable, more scratch resistant, and it's really for us the right material for a modern watch, modern high-end watch. And at the end, the product is very, very, very coherent. And it's a perfect example.
In your role, you oversee different departments bringing the watch together in the end. What would you say, how do you bring the ideas together fitting to the brand? And how is there a process? Do you have like inspirational meetings, or does someone come up with an idea, and you know, like, how does it work?
In a normal company, you have a very linear process.
Yes.
Step one, step two, step three, step four. And in Roger Duby, that don't work like this. I like to compare that to a forest. When the winter comes, it's not the biggest tree to say the winter will coming, be careful. Yeah. It's a very organic organization, and for that in Roger Duby we have an idea, a concept. The good example is the titanium. We want to do a very modern watches. And for that, every people have the possibility to influence the development of the product. That is very challenging because you move your brief during the 3 or 4 months, 4 first months, and after you stop, we stop and we produce that. But it's more efficient. You generate a lot of noise, but it's more efficient, and at the end it's possible to have a perfect product. Because in a normal organization you have a marketing brief, you study the market and you create a marketing brief, and after you design the product, you develop the product, you produce the product, and at the end when you finalize the product, it's not you lose a lot of things.
Okay.
And to achieve that, we make the decision to create a space in the company, and we have the a good example. We have front of the designer, it's the guys to program the machine. And these two people normally never talk together. Because one is very pragmatic and the other one is fly all the time. But now the designer become very pragmatic and the mechanician become very, very crazy, and it's a very virtuous circle because it's challenging the good way.
Yeah.
And that it's a good solution. And my role is just to manage.
Yeah. To balance them out.
To balance that and to give the vision of the client and to protect the DNA of the brand. That work, it's very fun. And that done, the product is very spectacular. And I think
it seems like a very dynamic environment.
Yeah.
Maybe also a quick environment. How long does it take to, maybe speaking of the central turbo,
For a movement, it's a very long process. It's maybe 4 years. But for a product like the Rainbow, that can be a very, very short because we start by a vision of the perfect sunrise. And after, we have all the people to find the solution to achieve the Rainbow. And it's very quick decision. We have a meeting, 2 meetings per week. To validate everything, and the product manager comes with the real stone, and we make the decision very quick. I think that it's the reason why also it's possible, and it's very motivating.
Great. There are a few questions I always ask. It's a more personal questions. What is the most important criteria for you when you choose a watch?
For me?
Yes.
The rarities of the for me it's very important to have a very small production of this model.
Okay.
When I buy a watch, I have a small collection. I know exactly the number was produced.
Oh wow! Okay. And is there maybe a memorable experience you have with buying a watch or having a watch?
Like my most memorable experience it's with Roger Duby, because I have a watch. It's after 10 years you receive a watch, and this watch was made by Mr. Duby himself.
Oh, wow.
And it was really for me a gift.
Yes.
And it's very emotional product for me.
So you keep that to your heart?
Yeah.
Yes. Amazing. And do you still remember your first watch?
My first, yes. It was a Casio with calculator.
Oh, you have the Casio calculator. Oh. Do you still have it?
No. It was, I think, in 1990.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Danke, Watchtime. Das ganze Interview findet ihr natürlich auf watchtime.net. Bis dann.